Okay, so today I'm going to talk about the problems with FHIR. So when you get into the world of health informatics, FHIR is usually the first thing that you look at because it's very popular and easy to implement, if I have to say. Because you are just given, you know, some sort of JSON to handle and you can make your own resources and it's very easy to start. And many of you have come to my YouTube channel to know more about FHIR. So if you continue down this way and you start actually creating applications for a hospital or a healthcare app, you will find that there are some problems with FHIR. And that's what I'm here to talk about today. So before that, I'd like to show you something. So this is the smart app gallery. It has hundreds of apps about you know, different things. Like it can be a bilirubin chart, there is a growth chart, there is an app to measure your blood pressure, and it shows you different charts based on that. And you know, there are so many of them. It seems like this is the way to go. Like in the future, there will be, you know, hundreds of these apps and we will all be using this regardless of the EHR that we are using. But I'm here to say that that's not the case. There is a huge problem with FHIR that prevents us from doing this. This would be an ideal world where this could happen, but it's not like that today. And to know more, I'll show you the US score profile. So suppose you want to make a blood pressure measuring app, right? And you just want to show a graph based on how much the blood pressure was throughout the day for a patient. Fine, you can go ahead and make that, but you need to make that specific to a FHIR profile. For example, if you are using the US core profile, and I'm just going to search for their profiles. And you can see that they represent blood pressure using their vital signs profile. And here they measure, you know, mention so many things about heart rate, oxygen saturation. And one among this is systolic blood pressure and diastolic blood pressure. So you can see that here they make it such that the observation dot component should take in a systolic, and observation dot component again should take in a diastolic blood pressure. So this means that, you know, you have an observation and you have the component attribute, and under that you have two separate components, one for systolic and another for diastolic. So that's how US wants to, you know, do their FHIR resource. Now come to another country, let's say India, for example. Like this is the FHIR implementation guide for the National Digital Health Mission that just recently came out, and we'll look at our profile. So here you can see that we don't have any profile for vitals. We only have an observation profile, and that too is made pretty open-ended. So, you know, you can, I'll zoom this in a little bit more. You can see that there is not much that they have mandated, except that there should be a code and that there should be a display, and this code and display can be anything. So if you go to Loink, you will find that there are at least 50 different measurements just for blood pressure. So it can be overwhelming for an application developer to choose which of these that he needs to pick and which to use in this particular resource. And they've left it, you know, open-ended. So if you make an app, coming back to the whole app ecosystem, if you make an app and you want your app to run on every country, regardless of where, which profile they are using, I'm sorry to say that's not going to happen. Your app should be made per profile. And that's the whole problem with FHIR. It's that they thought, when they came up with the idea that, okay, everything should be represented as resources. Yeah, that's a good idea. You can represent everything as resources. But the problem that they failed to address was each different region will have their own different requirements for how something is represented. And that, if you make profiles for each and every country, you end up having fragmentation of the whole ecosystem. So you don't have one thing that is FHIR. You have multiple different FHIR implementations. And it's, you can't just make one app that will run on every single platform. So what is the solution to this? And I have been also searching an answer to this, and that's when I came across openEHR or openEHR as they call it. So openEHR is something that is trying to do the same thing as FHIR, in that they are trying to make data as easy to communicate as possible, but they are doing it in a different way. So I'll again show you something that openEHR does. For example, the same blood pressure thing we'll take. So I'm going to something called the Clinical Knowledge Manager. So this is something that openEHR has, and they collect information about a particular finding. For example, blood pressure. Let's take blood pressure. I'm searching for blood pressure, and let's zoom that in for you guys. So you can see that under observation, they have one blood pressure, and this is already at version 2. So if I click on this, I'm going to show you the mind map diagram. You can see that blood pressure has all these different things associated with it. So it can have systolic, it can have diastolic, it can have, you know, the pulse pressure, the clinical interpretation, the comment. And the thing about openEHR, I'm going to refresh the screen so it shows you better. Right. So the thing about this is that it's just not only systolic and diastolic. It even has, you know, something like the location of measurement. It can be in the right arm, left thigh, whatever. The cuff size. So the place where they differ from FHIR is that they make a maximal data set. Instead of FHIR being 80-20 and them telling, you know, we will only take 20% of what is being used around the world, these people take everything that possibly can be represented for blood pressure. And then you take, this is called an archetype. So this is the blood pressure archetype. And you take this blood pressure, and then you cancel out things that you don't want using something called a template. And then you represent this, and automatically all of this gets coded. For example, blood pressure, we know that systolic, here you see that systolic is automatically being coded to the SNOMED CT observable entity systolic blood pressure. Same way for diastolic, it's being automatically coded. And with this, you can do really cool stuff, actually. You can automatically generate interfaces. You can do query on this archetype, wherever it is in the template. So I've been focusing a lot more on openEHR these days. And I've also been taking a course on SNOMED CT. Like, they have an implementation course that I've been taking, and it'll get over in another month. So then I'll come back and make videos on SNOMED CT in more detail, so that after I learn, I can make it better for you guys. So that's mostly what I've been exploring, that, you know, FHIR is a good transmission mechanism. It can be used to send documents across very well, but it's not a good source of storing the information per se. And openEHR seems to be better there. And there are a lot of open source implementations of openEHR, and EHR base is something that I've been using a lot these days. I'll be making videos about openEHR more in the future, for sure. This is just the beginning. So a lot of you have requested me to make videos on Smart on FHIR, and I will do that. The problem is, you know, if I make videos on Smart on FHIR and you have to make a different profile for each implementation, does it really serve the purpose of Smart on FHIR? We need to, you know, think more about where the industry is going as a whole. And I feel openEHR is more wholesome. It holistically captures the data better than FHIR. So I will be focusing a little bit more on openEHR and how they are doing things. So that's it for this video. This was just a short update about what I've been doing. I've also been working on something else. I've been working on Voice Intern. So this is a digital assistant that I've been creating, where, you know, you can just talk and it will capture data in a semantically meaningful way. The way we do it is just recording the voice, and we make transcribers listen to it in the background and send the thing back to you. and we can transcribe it to FHIR or openEHR compositions. That's what I have been working, and that's why I have not been making as many videos as before. But once I get more free time, I will definitely put out more videos for you guys. And thank you for all the support. I'm really grateful for this community. So see you in the next video.